The pictures on 3D cups have depth and seem to move, depending on the angle they're viewed from. It's a neat trick made possible by technology known as lenticular printing. A sheet of tiny plastic lenses is applied to interlaced images, creating a kind of graphic magic designed to entertain. A 3D cup fools the eye. Viewed from different angles, the artwork seems to come to life. It's all a carefully crafted illusion. Making 3D cups starts with clear plastic pellets. An extruder machine melts these pellets to a semi-liquid consistency. Then an engraving cylinder forms it into rows of tiny convex lenses. Water-chilled cylinders cool and solidify the plastic to form a sheet of lenses, and a gauge measures the lens's thickness. On the edge of the sheet, an inkjet printer then prints the optical resolution of the lenses, the type of plastic, and the lot number. The plastic then passes beneath a rotary blade that cuts it into sheets. The sheets land in a neat stack, and each contains around 40 lenses per centimeter. To confirm their size and alignment, they're viewed against a pitch test pattern. The sample is then magnified 100 times, and the thickness of the lenses is measured again. If they're either too thin or too thick, they won't focus. To find and measure its strength, a strip of lenses is clamped, and the top is then pulled to see how far it stretches before it breaks. Meanwhile, the scene to feature on the 3D cup is designed on a computer. The scene is copied, divided into very narrow strips that are then interlaced. These strips are then combined in a two-dimensional digital file. Before the final print run, test copies known as proofs are run. For the purpose of the test, sheets of colored plastic film will serve as the ink. Layers of colored film are placed in a cartridge with muslin paper in between them. The cartridge is placed in the printer, which will produce the proofs. These are then moved to an illuminated work surface and confirm that the images line up with the plastic lenses. If all is good, print plates are made and loaded into the printer, into which the lenticular plastic sheets are fed upside down. This is so that the images will be printed on the smooth side of the plastic sheet of lenses. Rotating cylinders transfer ink from the printing plates to the sheets, one color at a time. The machine's able to print several different 3D cup-sized images on each lenticular plastic sheet. Complete, the sheets are ejected from the press and stacked. The 3D printed sheets now head into a laminator. It applies a white film to the artwork. This film will protect the 3D images during the cup molding process. Next, the images are cut into their separate cup-sized labels and are then scrutinized on a light table. The backlight makes any flaws in the 3D image more visible. Satisfied with the clarity, the labels are cleared to be formed into plastic cups. Stacks of the 3D labels are then loaded into the cup-forming machine. This machine will process four different labels onto cups at once. In this run, each cup will have a different 3D image. Suction grippers pick up a label and drop it onto cup-shaped mandrels. The mandrel inserts the 3D label into the mold of a cup. Molten polypropylene flows into the mold, and it solidifies into a cup with a 3D label fused to it. The 3D cups are retrieved and stacked on their sides to await final inspection. They're then packaged for shipment. No ordinary beverage container. These 3D cups have images that appear to have both depth and motion. It all depends on how you look at them. Either way, I hope yours is half full.